Hello, my name is Rachel. I'm here at the Flint River Aquarium, and today I have Miss Ruby here, and it is about time for her to eat, and I thought it'd be a great opportunity to share with you how we feed our snakes here at the Flint River Aquarium. So I'll just set her down right here. And what we're gonna feed Ruby here today is a mouse. So I'll just move it a little bit in front of her. She's smelling it. There, she's checking it out. You gonna get it? You want it? Oh, there she goes. Good girl. Right. So I'm going to let her eat that for a little bit. Now, Ruby is an albino corn snake. And corn snakes are a species of rat snakes, and they like to eat rats. That's how they got their name, and other rodents. That makes up the most of their diet. But these snakes will also eat a variety of other different things, such as birds, lizards, frogs, eggs, and sometimes even other snakes. Some snake species will even eat fish, and when they're babies, snakes will eat insects. Rat snakes and corn snakes are non-venomous snakes that are found throughout North America. There are several different species. They all come in different colors. There's the gray rat snake, the yellow rat snake, the black rat snake, and then the corn snake, which we have here today, is also called the red rat snake. They are semi-arboreal, which means that they can sometimes be found climbing trees as well. Now, snakes play an important role in their ecosystem by keeping the rodent population under control. Since rodents are considered vermin due to their tendencies for carrying diseases and not being well liked, snakes play a part as natural pest control. A common theory of what led to the bubonic plague or Black Death in medieval Europe was that people killed too many snakes, which led to the explosion of the rodent population. The common belief of the time was that snakes were evil creatures, and since there were fewer snakes to control the rodent population, the disease spread and wiped out nearly 50% of Europe's population. While there were other animals around, like cats and dogs, to eat rodents, those animals are mammals and could also contract fleas and carry the disease. However, snakes are reptiles and cannot transfer diseases to humans easily. If we take a look at Ruby, she's swallowing the mouse whole. All snakes swallow their prey whole while eating. A common myth is that they dislocate their jaw to make that possible, but that's not true. However, snakes do have an extremely flexible jaw. The snake's lower mandible is connected to an elastic ligament in the front, which allows it to stretch open and move independently. The quadrate bone that connects the upper and lower jaw is also not rigidly attached to their skulls like ours is, so it's able to move freely, allowing the snake to open its mouth 150 degrees. Due to these adaptations to their jaw, snakes can swallow their prey three times their size. And to put that into perspective, if we had a snake jaw, we'd be able to swallow a whole watermelon. Rat snakes and corn snakes also have tiny teeth that are pointed inward, and these teeth allow the snake to tightly grasp hold of its prey and work its way down their throat. Like most non-venomous snakes, they are constrictors, which means that they kill their prey by squeezing it tightly and suffocating it. They do this by biting down on their prey and holding it down, and then wrap their body around, squeezing until their prey can no longer breathe. Well, it looks like Ruby enjoyed that mouse that she just had. And thank you for joining us. And make sure you stay tuned for more creature features. If you have any questions about Ruby or any other questions about snakes, please leave a comment below. Bye.